Hey guys, welcome to Survival Hunt. Today we'll be completing our birth and recruiting a new crew member. We'll also look at the different crew members we can recruit. Let's go. Let's put some rum here and click on finalize. Now we can add more sailors. Okay. So we have one more bed space here.
Okay guys, we finished to level up our berths. Now we can recruit a new crew member. As you can see, I have three applicants here. One is Ugly Jack, then it is Keen Peter, then it's Swift Steve. Every crew member will have three types of skills. So one is their attack skill, what kind of attacker they are, and the other two are the ways how they will work, like someone's health will be more, or someone will do something, someone can produce some more stuff in some workbenches and other things. So let's have a look. I have something prepared which I will share with you, that what kind of skills there are and which skill is best for you to recruit a crew member and how you can check that. First of all, let me recruit a crew member. So as you can see, this one is having one skill which is strong, then one skill which is laborer. Produces something on any workbench faster by 15%. Then this one is having attack speed increased by 10. This one is having produced something on the workbench 13% faster. And this one is having 13% chance to make two objects at the gunsmith workshop. And one more is alternative, which is aggression radius increased by 19%. Okay, so I will recruit this Ugly Jack. I will tell you why I am going with Ugly Jack. Except, okay, now I have one more crew member. Before the list, I want to share with you the things I was talking about, that whenever there's a quest, you can click on the crew member and you can check that it's Fat Steve level 1, Hot Supper, Strong and Thrifty. So these are the three skills I was talking about.
As you can see, I have this table in front of you. The first skills which we are looking at are the attack skills, like what kind of attackers we can have as a crew. First is Thrasher, then it's Skirmisher, then we have a Woodward, and we have a Hot Supper. Mostly it's like the kind of weapons you can provide them. First one, you can provide hammer, then you can give a ranged weapon like bow or something to them. Then you can give daggers and spears to these two type of crew members. We don't know yet what are other crew members skills, whether there are any or not. As soon as I will find it, I will update it. So as we all know that in the raiding, we know that it's not that effective to have a crew member which can save your base from raiding or fight the enemy who is there to raid your base. Maybe in future we can have a system where we can upgrade our crew members and they can fight any person who want to raid our base in a better way. Right now it's easy to fight them, and I think it's of no use to look at these skills, because anyways, any kind of skill you have, they won't affect you that much. So now let's go to the main kind skills which are there. So now we have the other skills which are there, which we have two for each crew member, two of them, as I showed you in the video. So first skill, as we look at, it's Master. Maybe there are more skills there, but I was able to find these skills which are right now in front of the screen. First is the Master, can make two objects, chance to make two objects. You can even take a screenshot of that if you want to have a detailed look on it. Then we have Healthy, increased health. So first thing is first, there's a percentage. There's a chance that, for example, for the increased health, there's a 15% chance to increase health by 30, or there's a 15% chance to make two objects. But different crew members have different percentage. Some have 15, some have 30, some have something. Once you will go into the zone and collect the coordinates for them. After that only you will be able to check the detailed description, but the main thing is you can check the heading of the skill, like whether it's master, it's health, it's hunter. So based on that, I will recommend you will go for any crew member based on this skill, so that at least you will have a rough idea. Then you can check whether there's you want to do it. For example, you will have a master skill for your crew member, and it can force like two objects. You have 15% chance, so you want to take a risk and just check that I want to get that crew member. Maybe it will have 30% chances or more chances for that. Then it's based on luck whether you will get it or not. So first of all, first check these skills which you want to, if you already have that skill with the crew member and you want to see whether there is a chance that you will get a higher percentage. As you can see that I have graded them, there's a grading from 1 to 10. For example, I have graded this chance to make two objects to 5. Okay, so the thing is, see, I have graded something with 2, some with 8, some with 10, some with 5, some with 1. So let's talk about them. First of all, let's talk about the skill which I have rated 1. So for example, I have graded attack speed increase 1, and then after that I have chance to make 2 armor to 1. Then I have graded chance to make speed increased to 1. So all the skills which are based on attacking the enemy, or like which will give you health, which will give you something like that, I won't recommend that. Second thing is, for example, there are skills which have graded 2. For example, maybe there's a 15% chance, 10% chance to make 2 objects in the forge, which is good, you are getting an extra object, but this shouldn't be your priority. First, your priority should be, first of all, laborer should be your priority, because produces anything faster. So there is a 10-15% chance to produce anything, because you have to produce everything in the game. So your priority should be the laborer, which will help you to produce anything faster. Whether it's 15%, 10%, it's better to have anything faster than a specific thing, because you are not producing any specific thing every time. Then after that, I would recommend that, for example, like a hunter, meat and hide production increased. So it's specific, but it's for something which you really want. For example, for the hide is a little bit difficult to get, as you have to fight someone, otherwise like getting palm trees or bamboo trees or any other kind of stones or something, you can farm them without even fighting. You can just roam around the zone, then you can farm a couple of stone or trees which are on the edges of the zone without fighting any enemy in the zone. Then after that, you will have for example, wood production is increased, those kind of things which are specific with the percentage. Because two objects in the forge is kind of not that good, because it will be two objects, but later on maybe it will come handy when you produce gun, it will be another gun. But now if you are producing hide, you will produce one more hide, which is really lesser chances. I will show you one more graph, one more table. Then what I was talking about the applicants. So as an example, I have created a table for the crew members, which I was able to find. So for example, I have Fat Billy, Canny Steve, Ugly Jack. So the names don't matter, but the skills, as you can see with the skill one, we have those attack skills, which are like what kind of attackers they are. And with the second and third skill, you can see I have just put the percentage here so that you will have a better idea. For example, there are two different skills which will help you to grade a crew member whether it's worth it to go for or not. First, we have 15% chance to produce two objects in the workshop. Then we have 15% health. As 15% health doesn't matter, but creating two objects is kind of okay, because it helps you to produce another object. Then we have hunter. Like you can see, there's a 33% chance to generate meat and hide production faster. And we have a rover skill as well. Rover, you won't be able to user, 33% increased chance of reproduction is really good, because 33% chance it's really likely to have you will produce hide and meat faster. It's not like you will produce two meat or hide, but the thing is it helps you to produce faster. Suppose it will take you 5 minutes to produce meat and hide, 33% time will be reduced from the time taken. So it's really worth it for these kind of skills instead of creating two objects, because there's a chance to create two, but this is guaranteed to have 33% reduced chance. As well as you can see for the gathering also, as we have 27% chance to gather herbs and berries. So there's 27%, but I won't recommend that, as you know that it's not worth it to send your crew members for that. And also the percentage, as I told you that the percentage, for example, as you can see here with the laborer, we have 15% chance to reduce production time for in any table for production with 15%, and here you can see it's 13% only. So there is the thing, like for example, if you have a laborer skill with a crew member, you already have 15%, then you should go for the other one. Maybe you will get a 20% chance or 13% chance, it depends on the luck. But I will recommend that if there is someone with the laborer skill, you have it already on 15%, but the other skill is also something which is really good. For example, there's a master as well with him. So if he have a master skill as well as labor skill, so that will help you to produce something with 13% less time, and also give you a chance to produce two items at some specific workshop. So I hope you understand all these skills and you will have a better knowledge how to recruit a crew member now. So guys, make sure to subscribe for more videos. We'll be creating some more videos on crafting and base building and zones and other things as well. Make sure to subscribe, share and like. Thank you for watching. See you next time.